spin how it feels. Wow, that bombed down a lot. Wait. Wow, that's the lowest. Holy shit. Okay. This is gonna be interesting. Maybe. This is gonna be
running custom setup, Pete?
Yeah, made a few changes. In particular, just like bumped the rear wing down to 4 and brake bias at 57 to the front. Apart from that though, most of the other stuff is fairly unchanged. It really likes running without traction control. I feel like if you have it up too high, it intervenes too much. So I've got mine at 3, and like you can sort of balance it nicely through the corner. It's insane, right? Don't forget pit strategies as well. This will require a pit stop. Although for the race, I have set the weather 2 slots of random, so I want to see how it handles that.
the front's going to be that severe. It's going to be cold, so we're going to afford to go lower on that traction control. Go even lower. What I am driving is the Metal Moro Honda, basically, and everyone else is in the Ginetta. So I like being different. We put a ban on the Sigma because it was too OP. But yeah, if I literally, the only way I can keep up with the Ginetta is if I drive to absolute perfection. Like, nail each brake marker, enable DRS whenever I can, as early as possible, just keep it on the track.
Yeah, so that Metal Moro looks like it's going to be a handful.
I was up like 1.5 seconds, so I can bring it closer.
1.5 seconds, yeah, that's not too bad.
It's basically just a challenge for me to basically nail every brake marker, keep the speed up around every single corner, and just abuse the shit out of DRS wherever I can.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
What gears everyone using on the uphill hairpin?
I think second, maybe second. Third. Yeah.
Fine, third, you're obviously more stable, but it just bogs down.
It does lean on the traction control quite a bit more as well, yeah. But yeah, exactly. Like, second, you get the immediate, like, torque.
I should have just jumped in the Ginetta and just made it a single mag. Okay. Have some air float. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, the understeer. Have to look for that button afterwards now. Ugh.
I was back and forth there for a bit.
Yeah, it was.
You guys are fast. Fuck hell.
I gave that everything I had.
Oh, yeah, that was still in the Metal Morrow, wasn't it? That's... I mean, I was going to say, it is close.
Again, I've done some very janky shit to deal with
very
this
questionable
piece of shit.
Yeah. Okay, well, I mean, fingers crossed the weather plays nicely for the race. So, again, I have set it to random for both just to see how it acts. But I guess we'll find out. If it is raining, then obviously remember to put wet tires on and remember to adjust your strategy as well.
And a personal note for me, don't crash into the bus stop.
We're looking all right for the moment.
Definitely going to need full fuel and definitely going to need tires because holy shit.
Oh, and don't forget to put fuel back in your car as well.
Damage, I'll turn that off for now. Hope this works. I don't think we're going to be going for more than 55 laps, so hopefully.
Under 30 seconds now.
Gonna need to drink after this.
10 seconds, remember to ready up.
This car bogs down.
Seriously, that DRS.
It's the only thing I've got.
Thank you.
car's actually kind of terrible in some of the corners here.
Yeah, I can imagine. Oh, I have to relearn full fuel handling.
Down inside watching that Nimbus just fuck off into the distance.
Yeah, I know the feeling. That's an interesting line.
Too much curb.
You still just pull away up the straight with that DRS, that's insane.
It's all I've got!
My left rear is starting to cop somewhere now.
I can't go any lower than minus 4 degrees camber, by the way, in this thing.
Yeah, I did notice that in the setup. It's like locked to that as a minimum.
Not alone.
Oh shit, is it actually?
Oh, what? Oh, I thought you guys were. Oh, yeah, I see him. Uh
oh.
Yeah, that's not too.
Whee! It better stay light rain. Otherwise, this race could get spicy. Wow, I can't believe iRacing made wet weather real.
race with the rain.
One lane behind.
In the LMP2s at Suzuka.
Two lanes behind.
Oh, I haven't actually... I didn't try that that week, but the LMBH is just insane. One insanely bad.
I will admit, I did have a bit of a tough time in the wet.
One lane behind.
Mostly because I didn't know what the bind was for windscreen wipers.
Here's two lanes back. One lane back.
I found it, like initially, I don't know if they've changed it in the patch, but you don't really need them. The rain almost wasn't that strong enough on the windscreen.
It's fine.
Ooh, rain on the main straight.
It's fine if you don't have anyone in front of you. It's horrible when you've got someone in front of you.
Oh yeah, it's shocking. It's disgusting. You can't see a thing. Yeah, there's a bit of spray being kicked up now around sort of main straight, turn one. The beautiful thing about this series is your DRS won't get disabled just because the session's declared wet. So you can still just fuck off up this straight, and I just have to sit there and watch it. If the rain does get harder, the understeer might pay off.
Oh god, that was my first track limit warning.
One lane behind. There's two lanes back.
I'm still astonished by the pace this thing is doing.
Yeah, it's holding its own.
Like everything is gone! Like,
yeah, in the bits of eye catch up and all the twisty stuff, you're able to hold it in front, down the straights. Oh, rain's getting heavier up the hill now.
Back.
Oh, hello!
Ooh, what's happened here?
I've lost the ability to change up and get through the gears.
Huh.
One lane behind.
Surely that's not an in-game thing. I definitely haven't set random mechanical failures on.
He's not driving a cyber truck, so it's not affected by water.
Now it's working again. Yay.
Just a minute. You had a boring race.
I was happy out in front, thank you. I never get to win!
Neither do I! Wait, no, I take that back.
was going to say you won that Le Mans race we did, didn't we? Surely that's another cut.
Yes, that was.
I was gonna say.
Understeers on entry, oversteers on exit. It reminds me of a certain car in ACC. Still seem to be hanging in there.
Yeah, I mean, my tires are still like in the 70s and 80s, so. One of the complaints that some people have had about multiplayer and random weather in AMS2 is that there'll be different levels of water on the track for different people, which obviously isn't ideal, but I mean, it seems to be everyone's going okay. It's still very light rain at the moment, like it's not standing water, for me at least.
How that wasn't a track cut is beyond me.
It's close.
One leg left. Oh, here we go.
Well, hello.
Still I'm starting to feel back. It now.
Oh yeah, we're getting slippery.
His two lengths back.
Turn, you bastard.
Yeah, the grip's getting away from us now.
Yes, I'm still inside enough to use DRS.
Oh shit, yeah, I followed you off there.
One left.
Oh, there's no grip out here.
Oh!
It's so slippery.
He's still there. It is clear.
Oh! Oh yeah, the track is definitely getting glossy now. The rain is well and truly here, lads. I think Derek's made the right move.
Yeah, I was contemplating that last lap.
It was just bucketing around, bucketing down as I came around that last corner.
We went past the pit lane by the time it started getting real heavy.
Yeah, instant regret. Oh fuck. Oh shit. We dropped it on the curb.
Curb is lava.
I wish my tires were a bit more lava right now. Yeah, I think that's the right call.
One leg back.
I couldn't see my pit box because of everyone else's bloody pit boxes.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
How do, can I tell what tyres I've got on?
Oh, you'll know when you get out of pit lane.
God damn it, Haynes.
That made it. Why did I have such a quick pit stop? What's going on here?
Yeah, I don't know why. I think I had damage on still.
He's on the right.
Oh, rip.
Oh, you'll know if you've got wets on. Bit worried I might have to splash and dash at the end, because I came in just before I would have been able to make a full fuel stop.
the last corner is so understeery now.
More corners to mirror understeer.
It's a way of life for you.
It's getting so dark as well.
My wet tires are getting cold.
It's not turning to snow.
Oh,
is it?
I thought I heard thunder there for a section.
Oh, it's really coming down.
It is bucketing now. The F1 stewards are having an aneurysm right now. Unrestricted.
Oh no, I love it. It's not helping me at all.
But it's there.
Exactly, it's peace of mind.
Okay, it's getting very sketchy after the bus stop.
Try following someone.
No thanks. This has got to be like storm conditions or something. I'm just waiting for like a lightning bolt to strike. Monsoon season.
Oh great, now we've got fog!
Oh lovely! Are you sure that's not just the rain hitting, like, that hard sideways?
I was losing a bit of visibility for a second.
Yeah, you might be right, actually. Ooh, almost lost it.
Haynes and Franco are literally parting the seas right in front of me.
Well, you should be fine in that boat of a thing.
Any corner I'm still on the track afterwards is a bonus.
What's the saying? Any crash you can walk away from?
Yeah, exactly that. Okay, we're good. Spa 2021, anyone?
Oh, we've done more laps than that. We've actually raced. I think there's a clip of like a 6 hours of the Glen race on YouTube, and it's like old ass clip on like Speed Channel or whatever, back when they were using the old Daytona prototypes, the ugly ones. And my god, that thing was like just an ice rink. The cars were just eating into the last corner barrier, no grip. It might as well be, yeah. God, there's still half an hour to go. At least I think I'm good on fuel now.
Well, I was about to say, surely...
Because of the lap times I've been doing, yeah, exactly. My main issue now is just holding off Spectre.
Dun.
Don't do it!
There's enough water to be an ocean right here somewhere.
Yeah, I actually traded my car for a boat, so...
battle between Hans Curry and Frank Frankfurt at the moment. Watch it! I can keep my car together. This is genuinely hard work.
I don't know how I held that.
That was quite impressive to see.
Thank you.
part of the track here.
Yeah, mine are at about half tread. It's not looking good.
You guys have tread?
Just me, or is it raining heavier again?
Honestly, I can't tell half the time because I'm always stuck in the Franco's rooster tail.
I think he's sleeping soundly. Yeah, the one time I choose not to stream as well.
It's alright, I've got you covered.
I will have to watch yours back, that's for sure.
The start of it was interesting.
What I like to hear. Who said people couldn't race closely in the wet?
I mean, I used to turn close loosely.
Well, you're all within like the same postcode of each other. Thank you. swear that was the longest, like, 15 minutes of my life. Finally got some heat into these things.
Oh god, I'm gonna need a triple rum and coke after this.
Oh, I only had 0.7 of a litre left. That was cutting it fine.
Did you actually have to fuel save, or were you still going flat out?
Nah, I was gonna go flat out or run out. That was the only options.
Despite the torrential conditions, the front of my car is still filthy.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I did kick up a fair bit of mud behind me.
Yes, I noticed that.
That point early on where, like, the rain started to trickle down, I'm like, oh, this is gonna get interesting.
Like, I saw a couple of drops, I'm like, hang on, are my frames dropping, or is that actually a thing?
Now, it's something that AMS2 does really well, the weather conditions, because it wasn't raining on one side of the circuit, but you get to the main straight and you start seeing the drips.
Exactly, yeah.
I love that. But, yeah.
The only thing I wish it did have is the rain radar thing that you see in a lot of games now.
Yeah, like, even iRacing's put that in recently, and they, like, I don't know, iRacing's just hit it out of the park, and it's, like, set the new standard.
GT7 did it well, too.
That's like, true, with the radar, yeah, exactly.
With not only the radar, but it also gives you the little graph that tells you how damp the track is.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can judge a little bit better on whether it's, like, inters or full wets or whatever.
Yeah, I wish there was more of that in this. I mean, there is, like, a massive UI update coming with 1.6, as they said in the dev update. So hopefully there'd be some more stuff added in terms of weather, or like even if you had a spotter or something, like crew chief, not like the external one, but the standard built-in in-game one. But yeah, I mean, that transition from dry to wet was probably, I mean, I want to say the highlight.
Yeah, what was it, about 3 laps and then it was wet's time?
Yeah, something like that. It's whenever you can see your slick tires, like, the temperature's massively dropping off, it's like, yep, gotta dive into the pits.
Alright, good battling there, Haynes.
Thanks, everyone.
Yeah, good fun.
Good race.
Yeah, I'm gonna call it there. Thanks for racing.
Thanks, guys.
Just before everyone buggers off, what are we doing next time? Are we gonna do this again, or Wheel of Death, or what do we want
to
do?
I'm happy to do the wheel, just to shake things up a bit, and then I guess, like, would we still want to do a longer race, or I guess it depends on the car, doesn't it?
I think you can do, I don't think there's many you can't, other than maybe karts would be a bit annoying in a longer race, but you can sort of base it off what the result is, I suppose.
Yeah, that works. I'm sure I'll figure something out, yeah.
If it lands on rental cards at Nordschleife, I'm going to go buy myself a lottery ticket.
Nah, it's supercarts at Nords, mate. Supercarts.
Or like Formula Truck anywhere.
Or like 1970s F1. Or just like the early turbo F1s where it's just nothing and then death. Everything.
I like them. They're fun.
Are they?
Yeah. It's like having a serial killer as a friend.
It's even more fun when you use H-pattern.
I just got to invest in one.
So good.
Let's be gone.
Anyway, I'm going to take off. I'll catch you guys later.
Yeah. Thanks for that, guys.
Yeah, thanks, guys.